not making any statements. If you want to ask me questions, you're free to do that.
Why did your client bring the guns in a
We're not answering that question. We're not answering that question. What's happened here today, why? Because it's a criminal case. That question is going to be answered in the courtroom, just like every other criminal case. This is no different than any other criminal case. And as far as Mr. Jones is concerned, it's the social media and the media who have turned him into a thug, who have labeled him a thug with no evidence whatsoever. This is not a situation where Mr. Jones ever wanted to be a thug or thought of as a thug. But because he's a young black man, all of a sudden he's a thug. That's what's happened here. There's no evidence of that whatsoever, and it's disrespectful to Mr. Jones and everyone else, every other black man in America who's young and black, to be called a thug because he happens to be black in this situation. This is the institutional racism that we deal with every day in the court system. There's no indication whatsoever that he was in any way disrespectful. There's no information at all that he was in any way did anything to say he wanted to be a gang member or a thug. He's a young black man charged with a crime. Therefore, he must want to be a gang member. He must want to be a thug. That label that was attached to him through social media almost got him fired, and it was completely unfounded. Mr. Jones did exactly what anyone else in his situation would have done. He cooperated with the police. He was arrested. He promised to be here. He showed up here this morning. He was polite to the police. He did nothing that would suggest that he was in any way trying to act as a thug or want to be a gang member. That's made up from social media, and that needs to stop. He's a young black man charged with a crime. Happens all the time. Let's just deal with the actual facts. And the facts of this case are that they found two guns in a carry-on bag that they said was his. He had no intention of bringing any guns into that Logan Airport that day. He had no intention of bringing any guns onto an airport that day. And I expect that the evidence is going to show that he had no knowledge of what was going on. Any other questions?
So then how did it happen?
I can't answer 100 questions at a time.
If it wasn't the intent, how did this...
I told you I'm not going to answer that. That's a question for the jury in front of a trial.
They say the guns were inside the bag with a label that had his name on it, in his bag, in his duffel bag. So what do you say to that?
The guns were in a bag with his name on it. Exactly. That doesn't make him a thug. That doesn't make him a wannabe criminal in this case. It doesn't make him a wannabe gang member. It makes him an individual charged with a crime. The facts are what they are. You have access to the police report. You saw how helpful he was with the police. You saw how respectful he was with the police. That's not a thug. That's not a gang member. And we have to address, in this country, the institutional racism that comes with every time a black man gets arrested. That's not what this is. All Mr. Jones wants to do is play football. He doesn't want to be a distraction at all. He wants to support his family and play football. That's his goal here. But everyone turned him into this thug and this wannabe gangster with no evidence whatsoever. We're suggesting you do your research before you start writing like that. In this case, we're grateful to the Patriots organization and to the leaders of the Patriots so that they didn't believe and read in and feed into what was happening on social media, where people were saying he was a wannabe thug and he was trying to get the guns past security. Nothing could be further from the truth. That's not what happened in this case.